Ja, hallo und herzlich willkommen zurück zu Star Control 2. Wir sind ja jetzt quasi auf der Suche nach einem Warp-Pod, um den Portal-Spawner zu bauen, wenn ich das richtig zusammen habe. Und dann wollen wir doch mal gucken, wo wir den finden. Ja, also wir sind hier im Quasi-Space und wir haben das hier, das sind alles quasi diese die Portale in den normalen Hyperspace. Wenn man das Spiel schon mal gespielt hat, weiß man üblicherweise, wo die hinführen. Deswegen werde ich jetzt hoffentlich, wenn ich hier meine Unterlagen richtig deute, auch gleich das Richtige auswählen, damit wir einen nicht allzu weiten Weg haben. Wir sollten, glaube ich, nach Pavonis, irgendwas Alpha Pavonis, ich glaube es war Alpha Pavonis. Und Moment, so, jetzt müssen wir mal kurz gucken. Also, wir wollen. Müsste das hier sein. Gut, dann machen wir doch einfach mal Navigate. Achso. Birxus. Dahin. Dahin. So. Und los. Also wenn wir hier nämlich aus diesem Quasi-Space raus sind, dann können wir ja auch endlich wieder unsere Star-Map benutzen. Das ist ja also die richtige Star-Map. Fällt die Orientierung etwas leichter. So. Okay, Star-Map. Sind wir richtig? Ja, wir sind richtig. So, und wo ich das gerade so sehe, wir sind jetzt sogar in dem Bereich, wo wir nach dieser komischen nach dem Herkunftsort dieser komischen Probes Ausschau halten wollten. Wir hatten ja irgendwie das ein, machen wir es mal mit dem Cursor, das glaube ich besser. Also entweder das hier oder das hier. Das sind die beiden Systeme, die in Frage kamen. Nachdem wir da die Linie durchgezogen hatten, durch die Sternsysteme. Theoretisch geht's halt, also, ja, ich glaube, wo waren das von hier irgendwo? Also, es war irgendwie so eine Linie. Guckt euch das alte Video an, da seht ihr es genau. Theoretisch könnte es auch hier unten sein, aber, kleiner Spoiler, es ist hier oben. Ich weiß auch gar nicht, ob hier unten überhaupt Sternsysteme auf dieser Linie liegen. Also, die beiden lagen auf jeden Fall drauf. Und deswegen fliegen wir da, wenn wir schon so nah dran sind, gleich mal hin. Dann haben wir nämlich diese blöden... Können wir vielleicht die Geschichte mit diesen blöden Probes mal lösen. Ja, dann machen wir nochmal... wie war das? Enter und dann Space. Dann nehmen wir mal die Maus wieder aus dem Bild. Das muss ja... stört ja nur. So. Wir suchen eine Welt ohne Oberfläche. Ja, das ist ja hier und hier im freien Raum scheint nichts zu sein. Und wenn wir uns mal ein bisschen an unsere Grundlagen in Astrophysik erinnern, die man ja wahrscheinlich irgendwo mal aufgeschnappt hat. Eine Welt ohne Surface, ein Planet ohne Surface, also ohne Oberfläche, das muss ja wohl ein Gasriese sein. Also gucken wir einfach mal zu den Gasriesen in diesem System.
Hello, visitor.
Ah, und das
we
war gleich richtig.
Slylandro. I am content to hover, a Slylandro speaker.
Okay.
Your presence here fills us with excitement.
This is
we
good.
Have gotten so few visitors over these many drawn. We hope you can stay to talk with us for a time.
Ja, das ihr seid überraschend freundlich. Allerdings, ich meine, die Probes waren ja am Anfang auch freundlich. Die sind dann ja nur irgendwann so blinkt ziemlich komisch. Weil ich auch ganz lustig finde, du scheinst ein Gesicht zu haben hier. Mund oder so, egal. I'm Perks, Captain of the Earthship Starship Discovery. What the heck are you?
Oh, this is terribly exciting.
Yeah, das hast du schon gesagt.
We'll be happy to tell you about ourselves.
Good.
If you will please, please do the same.
Kein Problem.
You see, we Slylandro have been extremely interested in learning about the galaxy. But our physique makes us incapable of leaving our gas giant home.
Hmm.
Therefore, we are totally reliant on our infrequent visitors to keep us informed about events outside this planetary system.
Mm-hmm.
And visitors usually only show up every few drawn.
Yeah, das glaube ich.
We hope that our newly deployed exploration probe fleet will not only gather information for us, but inform other races of our presence here as well.
Yeah, das ist ein bisschen, what are those glowy bits inside you? Ja, also es ist eine offensichtlich ganz interessante Lebensform, so amöbenartig, aber offensichtlich intelligent. Exactly how long is a drone?
The drone is our primary unit of time. It lasts for an interval equivalent to 4 million rotations of our planet.
Ach du Scheiße.
A drone is subdivided into 2000 Dranasa. Now please, our turn. Will you tell us about yourselves?
Most of us come from a large rocky world called Earth. Ja, das stimmt nicht mehr so ganz, da ich es ja heldenhafterweise geschafft habe, unseren Earthcruiser zu zerlegen. Eigentlich sind ja nur noch die... Obwohl, nee, unsere Crew besteht ja, stimmt. Unsere, die Crew auf unserem Flaggschiff besteht ja auch aus... Erdlingen, dann sagen wir das doch erstmal.
Yes, that seems to be the pattern.
Mhm.
Just about everyone who comes by here says they developed on a world a lot like that.
Ja.
As far as we know, we're the only sentient species who's ever evolved in the atmosphere of a gas giant. Of course, from what we know, most travelers like yourselves don't have much interest in gas giants. So maybe there are others like us, Thylandro, out there somewhere.
Muss eine interessante Evolution gewesen sein. Um es mal vorsichtig auszudrücken. We travel the galaxy in starships, seeking knowledge and contact with other sentients.
That must be great.
Ja.
To leave your planet and roam the stars.
Ja, das ist nicht ganz so einfach mehr.
We don't know how monotonous living on a gas giant for 3 or 4 drawn can be.
Das wären 12 Millionen Tage, ja.
Clouds, wind, lightning, clouds, clouds, clouds. That's it.
Ja.
We know a lot about clouds.
Das glaube ich.
If you've got any cloud questions, ask us. We have over 800 different symbolic references just to describe them.
Uh-huh.
Most of the time, when we aren't eating, we hover around and talk about what the clouds look like.
Uh-huh.
Of course, the only things we know about are clouds, food, and other Slylandro. So generally, that's what we think the clouds look like.
Ja, das ist überzeugend. Ja, also das ist hier sozusagen, ihr kennt euch mit Clouds aus. Da das Spiel allerdings schon etwas älter ist, glaube ich nicht, dass es sich auf Cloud-Speicher bezieht, weil das wäre sehr hilfreich. Ein ganzer Gas-Giant als Speicher, egal, ich schweife ab. We are particularly interested in studying unusual planets and life forms.
Oh, then you should go check out a planet orbiting a blue star not too far from here.
Uh-huh.
I think there is another blue star right next to it. We can't describe exactly where it is, but the people who told us about it, the Urquan, I think, said that it was one of the rarest worlds in space, and that as far as they knew, there were only 10 of these planets in this part of the galaxy.
Mm-hmm. Only 10 planets. Ob das vielleicht diese seltsamen Planeten sind, die unser Händler, wo unser Händler da Informationen drüber haben wollte, dessen Namen ich schon wieder vergessen habe. Oh Gott. 2 Blue Stars. Okay, gucken wir dann gleich mal auf die Star Map, wenn wir hier fertig sind. Our primary objective right now is to free ourselves from the evil Urquan.
The Urquan?
Ja.
The long brownish guys from the milieu, with all the eyes and arms?
Wahrscheinlich.
They used to come visit us regularly about 3 drons ago. They told us about all the interesting things they found from their scouting missions.
Mhm.
They were really nice.
Tatsächlich.
Why do you fight with them?
I think you're confused. Those aren't the Ökran we're talking about. Ours are green.
Uh-huh.
Stimmt, ja.
But okay. The Ökran were such good guys.
Yeah, but
they had lots of interesting things to tell us about.
Mm-hmm.
And they never got impatient with our questions.
Ich glaube, ihr verwechselt da gerade was.
Well, I guess a lot can happen to a species in 3-Dron.
Oder das.
By turning green and evil.
Ja, oder es sind zwei verschiedene Rassen. Mhm. Ja, auch möglich. That's enough about us for now.
Okay, but please, can we talk about you some more later?
Kein Problem. Probes? What probes are you talking... What are those glowy bits inside
oh
of you?
Oh my! I forgot! You creatures see in the visual range, and can see our... Well, we can't see them.
Oops! sorry.
What I mean to say is, they are... well, we use them when the male and the female... well, look! I'd rather if you didn't ask about them, okay?
Yes.
Especially not in front of Sol and Plummet. She's shy.
Aha. Ja, ist ach, das bist du da auf der rechten Seite. Mhm. Ja, wahrscheinlich du auf der rechten Seite. Ist, nein, da werden wir, gehen wir jetzt. Also hier, das ist ja nun... Ich meine, wie blöd müssen wir sein? Also, das hat doch nur der Letzte verstanden. Probes. What probes are you talking about?
You know, it's funny. We hadn't heard from the outside galaxy in a whole Genosa. And then, the Melnome come by and sell us a probe.
Die waren das,
and just
genau.
A few hundred rotations later, you show up. Oh, the probes? Right.
Mm-hmm.
Well, like we said, just a short time ago, a race called the Melnome stopped by.
Mm-hmm.
They said they had acquired some information revealing our existence, and they wanted to study us, if we didn't mind. In fact, the Melnome said they would pay us for the right to do so. I guess they are biology nuts or something. Anyway, in exchange for our information, they gave us a probe vessel.
Tell me about the other races you have visited, who have visited you over the years.
Oh, you
yeah.
Drawn.
Yeah, sorry.
Well, let's see. There was the Melnome just a few rotations back. Then we go all the way back over 3-Dron ago to the Ökran and the other Nilu guys. The Yuli and the Draw, I think.
Yuli and Draw, okay. Uh-huh. Yuli and Draw. Also Milieu sind offensichtlich wir feststofflichen, ja? Mhm. Milieu, what is... muss ich das auch noch fragen, weil ich es offensichtlich nicht weiß. Milieu, what is the Milieu and who are the Yuli and the Draw? And who are...
Let me remember.
Ja, mach das.
That was a long, long time ago. I was only a nymph then.
Ach so.
Oh yes, that's it. The sentient Milieu was a cooperative association of sentient alien species.
Mhm.
The Yuli, the Draw, the Taelo, the Melnome, the Faz, and the Ökran, who lived across a wide section of the galaxy.
Okay, was doch was anderes.
They talked to us fairly frequently for almost half a Dron. Then suddenly, the visit stopped, and we haven't heard from them since.
Mhm, irgendwas vorgefallen sein, aha. Mhm. Were there any other visitors here besides the Melnome and Milieu races?
Yes, there was another race. A highly sophisticated species of shaggy giants who made repeated trips to our world over a period of several Dron.
Mm-hmm.
They even installed a broadcasting satellite in orbit around our world, which let us talk with them whenever we wanted.
Was that praktisch?
They were called the... I'm sorry, I can't remember their names.
Ja, passiert mir auch.
It was a long, long time ago.
Ja, ja. Yo! Ich sage tatsächlich yo. Hm? Okay, naja. That sounds like the precursors. What else can you tell us about this race?
I wish I knew more of the information you seek, traveler. But we last saw the shaggy ones just over 39 Dron ago, and very little from that era has remained intact in our history, Chance. Hold on a minute. Let me consult with associates Joyce Lifting and Solomon Plummet. Joyce Lifting, who has a better memory than I, recalls that the shaggy ones were described as being worried.
Mm-hmm.
They were always hurrying from place to place, seeking knowledge as though they were in a desperate search for some important secret, some answer to a question that they never shared with us. Solomon Plummet remembers that the last time the shaggy ones visited our world, they came aboard a great circular starship, one even larger than your own.
Mm-hmm.
They had discovered their answer and were leaving to go somewhere, and they didn't tell us exactly where somewhere was.
Mm-hmm. This is extremely important to us. Don't you know anymore?
No. I have told you. One moment. Joyce Lifting transmits.
Uh-huh.
Joyce Lifting has remembered something else.
Good.
Though it does not relate to the Shaggy One's question, answer, or departure destination.
Uh-huh.
What my associate communicates is the description of a set of 10 worlds, unlike all others.
Yeah, die hatten wir schon mal.
The Shaggy Ones either discovered these planets, or, this is garbled, uh-huh, assembled them?
Uh-huh.
We were told the planets were, again, this is confusing, organized in some pattern, which in some way alluded to the Shaggy One's ultimate
fate. Das ist wichtig.
Mm. One of the worlds was described as orbiting one of a pair of blue stars.
Okay, das hast du schon erzählt.
Another of these worlds circled a large white sun. That is all we can remember.
Large white sun. Okay, das sind also Hinweise tatsächlich auf besondere Planeten. Und die Anordnung, wie sie in der Galaxis angeordnet sind, gibt einen Hinweis auf die Precursors. Das ist wichtig. Also, es ist, ja, sagen wir mal, es ist wichtig, um in einem, ja, bleiben wir dabei. Es ist, sagen wir, es ist interessant, sagen wir es so. Okay, can you give me details about your probes? Jetzt kommen wir mal zum wichtigen Teil hier.
If you are interested,
yeah?
In exchange for information about the life on source, the Melnor may offer to give us a remote exploration probe.
Mm-hmm.
It would roam the galaxy, gathering information and contacting alien races. And when it had filled its data storage units, it would return here and reveal to us everything it had learned.
Ja, nur leider funktioniert das Teil nicht mehr. What was the probe's program?
It was set on a 500 rotation mission.
To boldly go.
To boldly go where no catalog item 2418, remote self replicating robot explorer probe, had gone before.
Dankeschön. Das war. Okay, das war vorauszusehen. Die Reference musste kommen. Can you expand the probe's replication ability?
Well, we're not hardware people, so we only know the theory. What happens is that while the probe is exploring space, whenever it's not doing something more important, it hunts for asteroids and similar space junk, zaps it into its component parts, absorbs the debris, and when it has enough raw material stored inside, it manufactures a perfect replica of itself.
Da ist offensichtlich was durcheinander gekommen.
So even though we only found one probe, by now there should be hundreds of probes, maybe even thousands.
Yep, genau ist das Problem. Well, why then do your probes attack our ships?
Our probes do not attack. They have only defensive capabilities.
Offensive
behavior is not part of the instructions we programmed into the probe. To do so would be reprehensible.
Can we talk a little bit more about the probe's program?
Sure. What would you like to know?
Would you explain the general outline of the probe's program?
It was a difficult task for us, since we'd never done anything like that before. But for the most part, we just adjusted its standard program, which went something like scan for targets as defined in target list. If no current target, then select new target from the current targets list using specified priorities.
Okay.
If current position is at current target, then set current behavior to new behavior based on behavior priority settings.
Ah, yeah,
current behavior. Okay, That's the basic program.
Das ist sehr simpel,
I said
ja.
It was simple. And here are the tables used by the program.
Ja.
Target list. With associated target priority. Space vessel. 5. Transmission source. 4. Astronomical anomaly. 3. Planet bearing life signature. 2. Raw replication materials.
Ich glaube, da kommen wir zum Fehler.
Probe behaviors with assigned priorities. Communicate. 5. Record data. 4. Analyze data. 3. Seek
ja.
Replication materials. 999. Move the current target. 1. That's it.
Und da haben wir den. Wahrscheinlich ein einfacher Tippfehler, aber. Naja, hätte uns eine Menge Leute gekostet. You mentioned the probe's defensive capabilities. Elaborate.
That behavior was hard-coded by the Milnorme. We couldn't mess with it. Essentially, the probe will only fire its weapons if it has been attacked and cannot communicate with the attacker.
So, oder die Priorities sind durcheinander geraten. Yeah. And when defending itself, it uses its lightning weapon.
The probe is armed with a battery of missiles. Mm-hmm. It doesn't use its electrical discharge device in combat.
Yeah, what missile batteries? It always attacked us with lightning
That's
bolts.
That's impossible! It's inconceivable!
Damit werden replication materials gesammelt.
The electrical discharge device is used only for breaking down raw replication materials
yep.
into their component compounds for easy gathering.
Na, Captain Perks, haben wir es jetzt verstanden oder müssen wir noch weiter fragen, hm? Would you tell me about the replication behavior?
I'd be glad to. You see, the probe has the capability to seek out raw materials, process the raw materials into component compounds, collect the compounds, and then, when it has a sufficient supply, it can build a duplicate of itself. We decided that since we had only one probe, we should change the replication priority and crank it up.
Ach so.
So there would be more probes sooner.
War gar kein Tippfehler. Ihr habt's einfach verbockt. Verstehe. Ja, deswegen Beta-Testing. Wichtig, wichtig. What priority did you assign to replication? Ja, das
well,
wissen wir doch schon.
The factory setting was 2. In between movement at 1 and analyze data at 3. I told Joyous Lifting to set it a bit higher.
Joyous Lifting.
Let me ask him what he set it to.
999.
Oh, my. That was a bit extreme, wasn't it? Joyous Lifting told me he changed it to 999, the highest setting on the dial.
Yep, kind of quality control. This is... Ja, ist ja fast wie heutzutage in der Spieleindustrie. What is the... Ach, Perks, Mensch, wieso bist du so doof? Das haben wir doch... haben wir doch jetzt schon verstanden. What is the effect of the priority settings on behavior? Ne, natürlich, dass in erster Linie Replication Material haben will.
The way it works is that every time a behavior is completed or interrupted, the program selects a new behavior based on the defined behavior target priorities and what kind of target is currently selected. I think...
Ja, soweit richtig.
A really high priority would cause a probe to focus its attention on that behavior.
Bingo! Your probe does destroy ships, and I can prove it.
No, it cannot. It is not programmed for hostile behavior. What is your reasoning?
Think about what a probe does when it meets a ship.
Spaceships are the probe's highest priority.
Genau.
Because we want more than anything to make friendly contact with alien races.
Ganz genau. Und jetzt denke mal nach, was, wie sie zu ihrer Replizierung kommen.
The probe seeks raw materials and processes them in preparation for replication.
So, und eins macht. Think about the effect of changing the replication behavior's priority.
The answer is simple. It would spend more of its time seeking raw materials for its replication process. So what?
Ach komm, Mensch. Now, what will it do to ship, given that this replication priority is set to a maximum?
I don't see what you are getting at, but I'll play along with you.
Bitte, mach das.
Like I said, alien ships are the top priority target. Once a probe scanned a ship, it would instantly move toward it. Then, when it got to the ship, it would initiate communication automatically. When communications were terminated, a new behavior would be selected, and...
Ganz genau.
Uh-oh. a new behavior would be selected. And since the replication setting was set to maximum, the probe wouldn't get time to pick a new target. It would use the current target, the ship, for raw replication materials. It would process the ship, break it into component compounds with electrical discharges.
Guck an.
Oh no!
Yep.
What have we done? Traveler, you must tell us what we can do! How can we stop the probes from destroying all life in the galaxy?
Ja, gut, dass ich vorbeigekommen bin, ne? Welche beginnen wir? If I were you, I'd sue the mail on me. Ja, ich glaube, da sind hier nicht in Amerika. Das wird nix. I don't suppose you have some kind of mega self-destruct code or something?
Why, yes, there is.
So ein Glück.
You're a genius, Traveler.
Das stimmt.
Why didn't we remember that?
Das frage ich mich auch.
Oh, there's a problem, though. How are we going to transmit the code? Well, while we ponder that problem, at least we can give you the code sequence. That way, if you run into a probe, you can destroy it without getting shot off.
Dankeschön. Okay, ich denke, damit haben wir jetzt alles Wichtige bekommen. Wir haben jetzt den Self-Destruct-Code. Das heißt, wenn wir nochmal diese Probes treffen, können wir sie zerstören. Das ist also sehr hilfreich. Okay, ihr denkt weiter darüber nach, wie man das... wie ihr die alle auf einmal zerstören könnt und
Goodbye, human fluid sack.
wir fliegen dann mal wieder los. Okay. Ja, dann würde ich sagen, sehen wir uns beim nächsten Mal wieder. Also, bis dahin. Tschüss.